Oh!
Close, but no.
Hey everybody, I'm Mike Levy. We're back for another field test video and we're talking cross-country bikes. While we've got bikes from some of the big boys here, Trek, Cannondale, and Specialized, we've also included a smaller player, Revel Bikes. They've been around for a few years now, and this is their all-new Ranger. It's their third bike in their catalog, and it's got 115 millimeters of rear wheel travel and 120 millimeters up front. Revel says that they wanted the Ranger to feel like a fast, efficient bike. The front triangle, along with the rear triangle, both links, and the clevis are all carbon fiber, and it's all held together with a bunch of aluminum and titanium hardware. Geometry next, and I'm 5'10". This is a large size Ranger with a 473 millimeter reach. Head tube angle is 67.5 degrees, and the seat tube angle, 75.3. The back of the bike measures 436 millimeters, and the seat tube length is a smart 439 millimeters. Other details include a threaded bottom bracket as well as water bottle bosses inside the front triangle. There's two of them, or you could use one for a bottle and one for a toolkit. And there's another one on the bottom of the down tube. That's where you'll also find a thick pad to protect the tube from rock strikes. There's also some protection on the chainstay, and Revel has made enough room for you to run a 2.6 inch wide rear tire in the back of this bike. $7,200 American is going to get you an X01 Eagle drivetrain, a SID Ultimate Fork, SID Lux Shock, NV Carbon Handlebar, and Revel's own RW30 Fusion wheels. If you want to do a frame and shock and build it up yourself, you're looking at $2,800, and that's with the SID Lux Shock. Revel also offers a frame shock fork kit that includes this SID Ultimate and the SID Lux Shock, and that goes for $3,500 American. This bike, as you see it here without pedals and those Schwalbe tires, weighs 26.23 pounds. And Revel says that a frame comes in at 2,900 grams or 6.4 pounds with a shock for a large. Okay, that's enough about the details. I've been riding the hell out of this bike for the past few weeks, and let's get to that.
Time to get into the good stuff, but first, tell me about suspension setup.
Well, manufacturer's suggested settings, as always, with suspension, and then the tires, we put on those same Schwalbe tires to keep everything simple and comparable across all of the bikes. I also want to mention, Revel did a really good job here speccing the bike for its intentions, which is descending. We're going to get to that. So it comes with short stem, a big old wide handlebar, a long travel dropper post.
So nothing you felt like you would have wanted to change there.
Yeah, yeah. For this type of bike, it's ready to go.
So, Mike, how did it perform on the climbs?
Yeah, we have to talk about that before we talk about the descending. And the Ranger has 115 millimeters of rear wheel travel, 120 millimeters up front, but it feels more like a trail bike than a cross-country bike. It definitely could get up and around all the things, but you gotta plan ahead a little more compared to the racy bikes that you're on.
So not quite as quick handling.
Right, and then compared to something like the Cannondale Scalpel SE, that bike really dominates the technical climbs. It's short, it's nimble, it feels like it could just snake in there and stuff. Mm-hmm. On this, you're thinking a little bit more, you're taking a little bit wider lines. It does feel a little bit more manageable in the really challenging stuff than the Spur though. Geometry-wise, it feels like a trail bike more than a cross-country bike, mm-hmm. and that's what lets it really excel on the downs. We're gonna get to that. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it does well on the climbs for sure. It's just obviously not an XC race bike and it wasn't made for that.
So that's climbing, then we took the bikes to the downhills.
Yep.
How did it fare there?
It really came to life the faster you went. So that was opposite of some of the bikes that I tested, mm-hmm. That seemed to suit slower speeds and more of that like picky choosy, you know, you really gotta think. Where this bike, I mean, you still have to think, of course, but you can let off the brakes. It tracks the ground extremely well and the cornering was great. Even when things got tight. So let's talk about the Ranger compared to the Spur for a second. This bike definitely had the edge when things got a little tighter and slower. It seemed like a little more, just a little quicker to get through those corners. It carried speed easier, it was a little more eager to get out of the corners too. Whereas the Spur felt a little more calmer when things were fast and rough. Mm-hmm. And then both of them seemed pretty dang equal when you're rolling into that steep stuff.
And then of course, like all the other bikes, we put it to the time lap test.
Of course.
How did it fare there?
Yeah, it was fourth overall on our time lap, but it was second on the downhill, and that's sort of what I expected. It was a little bit behind the Spur, just a couple seconds behind, and then the efficiency test, I'd had one of the slower times, but on the trail, I mean, it felt fast as hell, so there you go.
Let's get into the components. Any standouts there?
Yeah, well, I think the big standout thing is that there were no issues. So on a handful of these other bikes, we've definitely had some things. We've had some broken rims, we've had some bushing play, you know, this and that. This bike has just kept running flawless, and that includes Revel's own wheels. These are their fiber fusion wheels, and they've held up extremely well, so no issues there. The Sid fork has been running well, and then four piston brakes on here, so no issues.
Okay, it's time for pros and cons. What are some of the good things about this bike?
Well, I think the obvious good thing, because I've said it over and over again, is that this bike was made to crush the descents and it's ready out of the box. Where some of these other short travel bikes are coming with narrow handlebars and little longer stems, longer seat tubes and shorter dropper posts. This thing, right out of the box, ready to go. And I mean, it also looks great. Look at this thing. I think it's the best looking bike here on the test. And from the feedback that I've seen from other people, they like it too.
About some of the things that you don't like quite as much about this bike?
Well, we have to go back to what I was just saying. This bike is made for the descents, and it's all about that balance, right? And if you have a bike that's better for the descents, it's obviously not gonna be as good on the climbs, no matter how good it is on the downs and how capable it still is on the climbs. It's still not a climber's bike, you might say.
So whose bike is it?
Well, I think it's for somebody who likes to have a lot of fun on the descents, just like with the Spur, and doesn't feel held back just because they only have 115 millimeters of travel. You know, they don't have 160 millimeters and they don't care. And they may do a whole lot of long rides, but they still want to hang it out and get a little loose on the descents. So they're probably wearing baggies despite me wearing Lycra during the whole video. They're probably wearing knee pads and
Yeah. They're
probably having a lot of fun. So that's it for Revel's all new Ranger. It's a ton of fun on the descents, and that's obviously where they put their focus on. It's still a blast on the ups. And speaking of that, why don't we go for a ride?
9 mile climb, here we come.
Here we go, another lap. Stay tuned for more video reviews and roundtable discussions from the cross country field test. Let's hit it.